Hello everyone and welcome back to more Baraku Emblem. Remember to subscribe if you like what you see and let's get into it. I'm not really bringing along the cavalry force since they're quite inept, dismounted, and I don't really have any flying units to bring. If I remember correctly, in Fire Emblem 3, Paula and Minerva were still quite good inside, but not so much the case with these guys. Like Hardin gets gimped without his horse. Look at his speed compared to somebody like Athena or Wolf. Sedgar still got it. And we have to bring Baraku, so yeah. And I'm gonna try to bring around with four, play around with four, so we got last chapter. And, Edsel. We'll see what he's made of. Yeah. Let's go. Of course, our archer started up front, that's inconvenient. So I guess this is a Talus castle, so that's interesting. What the hell? Garneth! Are Garneth and Violent about to toss hands? Elise is here too, even though I didn't deploy her. Yeah, I have Imhulu, and I will toy with you. Where's Boa? Please don't tell me. No. Okay, this was a genuine blind reaction. I did not expect this. Okay. So they just did split up my army. God damn it. Low blow, Baraku Emblem Dev, low blow. And I forgot to give Violent a weapon. Shit. I'll just give him one of Athena's iron swords. Yeah, I guess this is... Like, I saw that. Hold on. Weapon trade. I'll just take this, thanks. I saw that there is an area up here, and I was questioning, why would you ever go up here? There's literally no point, because all the chests are down here, and there's no bonus, but then they get you, alright. And all my mages are over there, too. And my thief, okay. Well, I'm glad I deployed Horus, since he's gonna be the rock that holds this shit together. Oh god, that's tough. This is like my ultimate B team. Whatever. Horus will pull through. As for up here, since all my good units spawn on this side, I really shouldn't have much of a problem with them, I would imagine. Let's just lure him out, I guess, or send this dude forward. Shit. No reason not to. Yeah, I thought reinforcements would come up from there, but then I was like, no, because there's doors, and if I don't open those doors, then there's no way the reinforcements are gonna do that unless they reinforced with thieves, which would be random. Yeah. You know, there's a bit of 5 points history. You know, I started this channel originally because of the whole Forbidden Fire Emblem YouTuber, you know, the Mango situation. Because he turned out to be a quite decent fellow. And it seems like, as time goes on, more and more of the people I enjoyed turned out to be indecent fellows. Because today, as of recording this, because I recorded 3 Baraku Emblems episodes in one day, seems like Dan Avidaniel from the Game of Grumps, who I used to like quite a bit. I haven't watched their stuff in recent years because, you know, Game of Grumps is one of those channels you just kind of grow out of after a while. They're not that interesting once you become older. But, you know, still pretty nice stuff for the most part for a younger audience. And it turns out that Dan Avidaniel man, or at least as the accusations go right now, was the child grooming type. And that's just not good. So it seems like YouTubers especially just have a high probability to turn out to be unlikable individuals. Which is, oh no, that's not good. I'm a YouTuber, oh no. Oh no. No, I don't want to be cursed. Oh, yeah. So hopefully I never turn out to be like that. That'd be quite unfortunate. Even with the armor slayer you went off, that's pretty sad, honestly. Alright, we gotta do some cleanup real quick. Just some quick cleanup right here. And this guy should go down to an iron bow shot. No need for the silver. It just seems like the more and more time goes on, you know, there was that pro Jared. I used to like his stuff a lot. You know, pro Jared. Oh, no, he cheated on his wife. You know, I saw his penis on Twitter. It was very not flattering. Oh, nice dodge. Very skillful dodge. Good job, Athena. Athena's been more useful than I originally thought she would be. Speed up, bump at level HP. Cool. Alright, cool. But I think she's level, close to level 10 at least, yeah. You know, me and my friends bonded over seeing that man's junk on Twitter. I was there live in the lunchroom as he dipped below a million. It truly was. Truly was something, alright. high school was a weird time, but yeah. And then, you know, it turns out a lot of the Smash people, which was another community I was quite fond of and still actively participate in to this day, where the keyword. You could use a bit more strength, actually. Well, it turns out that a lot of people, it seems like this year, well geez, no, it's been more than a year. More than a year at this point, that everyone you like in life is just not doing too well. Let's see, who do I still like? Ooh, Dodadoya and his Dragon Ball FighterZ videos. I like those a lot. Those are really good. But yeah. It's just hard to, you know, like, gee willikers, come on. Dan Avidaniel, you're such a nice guy. I think, you know, the thing is, right, with that and the Mango situation, the Forbidden Fire Emblem YouTuber, is that they were actually pretty good. You know, Dan, great at music, loved his cover of Take On Me. Some of his original stuff was a bit too inappropriate for my taste, but, you know, that's whatever. And it's like, oh, you're so good and talented, and, like, you know, the Shadow Dragon Let's Play with Mecha, one of the best Let's Plays on the internet, in my opinion, so funny, they have such good chemistry. And then, you know, the Game Grumps, again, they're Fire Red Let's Play of the Game Grumps, one of the best Let's Plays of all time, in my opinion, just because of how high quality it is. They used to be drilled, talked about a lot of interesting stuff. Very good Let's Play. Oh no, but now that's ruined because Dan Avidaniel, and then JonTron's racist. And then JonTron is racist, yeah. Honestly, you know, what am I even saying? Yeah, I was gonna say, you know, racist is probably the least bad of sexual offender and groomer. You know, I'm getting, I don't know. The thing is, I shouldn't have to measure this at all, but that's just how society is now. With all these YouTubers that I grew up with turning out to be, pretty schnasty. It's very unpleasant, I must say. Alright, you can go up to the pillar, so yeah. I'll just wait for Wolf, since I don't really want Athena getting wrapped up in all that. Yeah, extremely unfortunate that this, like, it's like, is it so hard not to be terrible? Really that bad? Can you just not do it? Can you just, can you just maybe not do that for a couple seconds? This map's pretty easy so far. You know, I was expecting more of a Kaizo hack. Like, I guess some chapters have been pretty stupid hardcore, like that one chapter with the infinite reinforcements and the wyverns, but we have the warp staff, so it wasn't that bad. I just... Meteor? Meteor? Is that... Wait, that's Garnef? Garnef is coming for me. Wait. No, that's not right. Let's see. Meteor. Let's run away for now, actually. This is taking a very big turn south. I do not want to get hit by Garnef. Yeah, it's just like, ooh. Like, all the people that I liked as a wee lad have turned out not to be hippest and coolest of people, which is quite upsetting. Oh, quite upsetting indeed. I like my own little YouTube community I'm forming, though. That's been pleasant so far. Let's see, what's your attack? 18. Of course, only taking one damage from this sniper, goddamn. Alright, get over here, you bum. Get over here, you bum. Well, I run away from Garnef. I hope he despawns eventually, because if he doesn't, that would be pretty bad. Alright, he's coming at me real quick. Pathetic. Oh my god, the crit, though. The crit. No physic. That's baby shit. Okay. So, Garnef. Math. Is that in Hulu? It has infinite uses, so I think it's in Hulu. It's a very bad translation of in Hulu is what it is, but yeah. Regardless, Forrest, take him out. Alright, yeah, then I guess I'll just have Etzel do it since he's close for leveling up. Let's see, skill 9, skill 5, more accurate, yeah. I think I might replace Anna with Etzel, actually. Just seems, since he's closer to promotion, that was a terrible level up. Never mind, Etzel, you're benched. You're benched, good god. Come on, man, you gotta do better than that. But yeah, how's this Garnef situation gonna play out? Let's see, info, turn 7. DS Fire Emblem, he would usually disappear by now. Good god, okay. Actually, is this gonna be the gimmick of the chapter that you can't beat Garnef? Just putting him in direct path of the hallway and there being no alternate paths would be an interesting design choice from their part. Am I gonna have to give somebody up? Because if so, it's gonna be Barst for sure. Alright. Actually, no, I don't have to give anyone up. Let's see, your attack is 24, ooh, but I have 5 res. So let's see, 24, attack, okay. So Wolf can take 2 shots. So maybe I lure him in with Wolf, and then evacuate with everyone else. Let's see. Let us see here. And Sedgar, how much are you rocking, actually? 2, and less HP, 2. Let's see. Move 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Nope, okay, so... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'll wait there. Yeah, so now I think I just line everyone else up in a neat little evacuation plan to get past Garnef and then have Sedgar block him off for a while. Sedgar and Wolf. Alright. Let's not have you in range of that. Actually. Let's just go up here. And then go up here. And let's see how that works out. And then I think I'm gonna... Anyone here have a voluntary? Well, we have heals, so it doesn't really matter anyway. Then I think I'm gonna go Glock this meteor guy, since he's annoying. That's the attack. Only 13. Yeah, we're good to advance through here. And we have Boa up here for the heals, so it don't really matter all that much. No siree. Alright. And it doesn't look like this map's gonna have reinforcements, which is good. Let's see, Garnef, what will you do now? Okay, going for that guy, but you missed. Okay. So now we can just box him in, I think. With these two. Yeah. Okay. That's good. And Wolf has a voluntary, so that's fine as well. So you get boxed in. Get boxed in, alright. Now the rest of the units can run for their lives, their sweet little lives. Let's go. Boom, boom, boom. All gas, no brakes. We gotta run away from Garnef. That is the primary objective at the moment. Actually, what's his speed at? Only 6, yeah, we should be fine. No doubles. No doubles. The problem, I think, is going to be fighting this fucking Shadow Dragon. Or, excuse me, Demon Dragon. Yo-ho. Let's see. Yeah, that is going to be a problem, actually. Oh, anyway. But now we can run away from these guys, at least. From Garnef. And just be on our merry way. Alrighty. Okay, yeah, that's Tomas, not Sedgar. Okay. Wait. Tomas can't make it. Wait, what's your attack? 24. But I have 4 resistance, so it should be fine. Actually, we can take a hit. Gonna be close, though, Christ. Not this blocking was not a very effective blocking. Oh, they're going for wolf. Why are you going for wolf? That's dumb. You're dumb. You're a dumb boy, Garnet. Yeah, hit me with your Impulu. Oh, you hit. Okay. Anyway. So now let's just keep having everyone else run away. Let's see, this guy only has like 16 and 2 defense. Let's see. Wait, so what's your HP? 16 and 2 defense, so I need 18 attack. Which I have right here. Get one shot by Horus. Nice. Nice. Got a pure water, that's cool. This dragon cannot reach the door, which is nice. Very nice, very good job, Horus. Alright. I gotta keep blocking off Garnef. Item use, Volunary. I was giving me 20 evasion, so now he's even more likely to hit me. But I gotta use it to just block him off, you know? Let's see here. Do it as far as I can here. Staff heal. Muraku should be go. Res 6, res 4. The next turn I'll lure down that mage with him, I suppose. And then I think we want Sedgar to take on those guys. Let's see. Zagaro the Hunter. Yeah, okay, so because of the pillars, he actually is pretty effectively blocked off now, which is good. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Nice, okay. So now Wolf can go have a little playdate with Garnef, and he should be fine. Worst case scenario, we can just rescue him with Boa. Check it. Get body blocked, ho. Next turn, we can just have Sedgar lure in that mage. Yep. Why are you insisting on hitting me, is my question, buddy boy. Item use, Volunary. I would really appreciate it if you stopped, actually. Let's see. And I'll just equip my iron bow, should be enough for a stupid little mage. Nice. Alrighty. Just have everyone move down at an orderly pace. And Boa does have the rescue staff, so if need be, we can just get him out of there. So yeah, it really seems like Garnef just isn't gonna fuck off ever. Which is an interesting design choice, honestly. Pretty bold of them to go. Stop hitting me! This is literally the third time in a row you've hit me, despite the odds. It's really dumb. Like, actually really dumb. God, I didn't have physic either. It's on Mathis still, I think. Supply. No, it's not worth using a fortify. Alright. Staff mend, Zagaro, you're gonna need to fight the Shadow Dragon, so you need to get up to snuff real quick. A Violin, just take out this one. Or not, I guess, okay. Go get him, Tomas, and then hammer this one. Alright. See, and you have 38. So then next turn, let's lure out that guy. But then after we take out the Shadow Dragon and get the treasure, it should just be a straight shot for the throne room, actually, which is nice. Unfortunately, I need to Volnir again, since this dude's being a little bitch baby. So please, refrain from hitting me again, actually. Thank you, Christ. And remember, Wolf has 7 moves, so if need be, I can just outrun Garnet. Because let's see. Yeah. So once the time comes and I feel comfortable with my distance gained, I'll just run away with Wolf. And then just have Sedgar keep luring these guys out. One at a time. Okay, that guy doesn't have a javelin, good. Wait. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That was not a good choice to have that guy stand there, yeah. Very poor choice, actually. Since he only has 9 HP, goddammit. Is it really worth resetting over Barst? Probably not, honestly. If he dies, I might just roll with it. Although that axe would be quite a loss of money. This is a real asshole chapter, the more I think about it. Like, come on, bro. Meteor Mages, Garnef. Come on. You're better than that game. Okay, Meteor Guy, don't move. Okay, nice dodge, Wolf. Okay, yeah. Good. Good, 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 good. Alright. Why don't we bust out the silver of the killer ball on this guy, because why not? Yeah. So Mr. Meteor doesn't move, which is good. Armor. These enemies sure do deal a lot of freaking damage. Alright, I'll just have this dude drink a Volinary. Why not? I have plenty of them. And then, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so she's one space off. Now what we want to do is avoid this fun fellow. So let's see, and then let's have Sedgar. So we want Sedgar to go on this tile right here. So he can attempt to attack the meteor guy in the future. And this is out of that guy's 2 range. So that should be fine. That should be fine, yeah. Expand to this guy, I guess. Okay. Now, Wolf, you just keep on hanging on there. Friend of mine. Garnef can just keep on missing. Nice, okay. I am short here, but I can just go by this guy's range now, which is nice. Alright. Meteor me all you want, it won't unfuck your mom. Yeah, this map really just said, here, have a free Garnef. Alright, now it's time to run. Now it's time to run, unfortunately. Alright. I'm just gonna bust out the killer bow so I have a chance of one-rounding that sniper. Because it gives me 39 crit. Alright. Let's see, who do I have here? Let's see. So now this is the part of the plan where we actually run away from Garnef. Can he attack me? No, he can't. Okay, good. Good, good, good. Wait. Yep, nope. I am immune from being attacked by Garnef. Very cool. Alright. Now let's just hope I can outrun him. And, like, play the map at a fast enough rate. Okay, nice. One rounded. Cool. Oh god, it's a Garnef. Okay. So 23, attack 20. Jesus, what a tough guy. All right. Okay. So what I need to do here is... he only has 20 attacks, so I'm good to go. I need to get some critical hits on this fight. Let's see, defense 16. Attack 28. I should do a decent amount of damage even if I don't crit, but critting would be preferred. Let's see. And a dodge would be nice, because then I can attack next turn, because I cannot heal with Maria. Let's see. Yep, so... if I went right here, the dragon would just attack me from one range. So I need to go right here, if this process is going to be speed at all. Do I have that right? Let's see. Yep, so directly beneath it is two spaces away. So I will equip the killer in the hopes of getting epic crits. Does anyone else need healing? I don't even think Athena can damage it, yeah. But I'll just heal her just in case, because why not, actually? Staff. Heal you. Alrighty, cool. And if I open this door with Lind, it won't be able to reach because of all the pillars and whatnot. Door open. Wait. Alrighty, cool. Nice, actually. Very nice. This is working out very nice, considering we had to fight literally Garneth. Yep, just keep gaining on him. Yep. And then we should probably take advantage of all the move we possibly can here. Just get as far away from him as humanly possible. Yep. Yep, yep, yep. And if need be, I can just sack Barst. This is a pretty intense chapter. Good job, Eric. Well, I blame you, man. You managed to make a pretty good original chapter. I'm feeling the burn right now. Yep, come on out of your little hidey hole and get crit, preferably. Ooh, skillful dodge by Sedgar. Unfortunately, no crit, which sucks, but I'll just be able to attack him anyway, so it doesn't matter. And he didn't even get physics. Nice. Alright. Time to finish you off, fiend. Get killer bowed, Omega low. Nice, alright, cool. So that's that. That is that. And now Lind can freely just go get the chests. Hopefully they have good rewards, considering all the effort I went through. And let's see, what do we got here? A physic and an Elfire. No problem for me. Alright. Let's head off. Oh, I accidentally waited instead of stabbed. That was bad, but whatever. Let's get Horus out on the battlefield too, since I'm enjoying using him quite a bit. Maybe just heal him up to full. With a boa. Because why not? We have lots of heals since I've sold some of my stuff. And for the love of God, keep running away from Garneth. Just go. Maximum speed. Run away. We don't want a piece of him. We don't want a piece of him. Jeez, this is kind of the first time in Fire Emblem I felt genuinely afraid of Garneth, because in Shadow Dragon you just gotta, like, turtle for the first six turns, and then it'll fuck off, and then a new mystery. You have a overpowered Starlight user to kill him by the first time you actually counter bomb this. It's like, whoa. Oh, gotta get away from Garneth. So good job, or Aku Emblem Dev, I guess. Yeah, wow, we really do gotta get away from Garneth. We gotta get Veriku's ass on that throne. Right quick. Shaver, ooh, that'll be good for later. Alright. Alright, you go here. I'm gonna heal you up. Alrighty. Jesus Christ, these guys are getting tough. Speed 15. Might just go for that hero. Just take him out. Okay, so let's see. What's your range, actually? Okay, let's have the boys move up, but not too close. We don't want to get too close. Let's mend. Skill up and level up, blah. Just keep on running away, I suppose. Yeah. And I guess we can just have Wolf re-engage if we need to by healing with Maria first. Yeah. Right now my priority is trying to just stay away from him. We are running away from Garnath right now, oh god. Yep, he's gaining, alright. Alright, and what's in this chest? Guiding Ring? Ooh, nice. So Etzel is a lot closer to that than Anna is. And will be an interesting choice, I guess. But yeah, let's just go. Keep on moving forward. Right, I don't really have a choice now, do I? Let's just lure these guys out with Sedgar, yada yada. We're still a decent way ahead of him, which is nice, I guess. God damn it, okay. So, I'll put Baraku right here. This guy right here. Mend him, TF up. Alright, 26, so he can block Garnath again if need be. Get Horus up. Let's just get these guys up. Yeah, we really was not expecting to see Garnath this map. I'm not gonna lie. Okay, so this guy's coming, but I don't really believe in his ability to defeat Sedgar. Alright. You missed. Actually, didn't even miss, he was just bad. Okay, yeah, we need to go. Alright, Lind, what are you gonna get for us now? Angelic Robe. Ooh, I'm gonna give that to Violent for sure. Alright, so let's see this turn. Let's see, what's your speed? Speed 6. Speed 8. And what's your attack? 16. So 16 minus 3 is 13. Okay, so you live around for sure. Weapon, equip, javelin, because why not? We just need to really get this show on the road right now. Like, actually, he's coming. I wonder if you were supposed to sacrifice a unit this chapter, but because I power leveled Wolf, I didn't have to. Because in Genealogy of the Holy War, there's, you know, a mechanic where you're like, oh god, gotta sacrifice somebody, you gotta do it. But then you can just be like, no, actually, I trained Larsa, so she actually won rounds Ishtar. You were supposed to get a crit there, my friend. God, this is gonna suck. Okay. We do have an Armor Slayer. Actually, what's this dude's attack? 26. Alright, we should be fine. And then Sedgar and friends take out the hero. Oh god. Okay. Let's just fight Mr. Hero Man right here. Okay, good. Very good, Sedgar. Very good. You're a very good man, Sedgar. Very good unit. I'm proud of you. Wait, hold on, what's this guy's attack? Okay, he can't even reach, so it doesn't matter. Alright, now we just have to take out this punk right here. And I think that is the job for Tomas Gaming. Take him out. Alright, Tomas, strength. Oh god, the good Tomas level up. The good Tomas level up. Alright, so let's see, what's your move? 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, alright. So if we move up with all of our guys this turn, yeah, okay, we outran Garnath successfully. For the next turn, I'll just have Wolf go up and assassinate that guy. The boss of the chapter. And Violin, let's see, what's this guy's attack again? 16. Let's see, this guy doesn't have anything. So let's just go up and chill. Let's just chill. Let's just chill. Alright, yep. Cool, cool, cool. Alright. Wolf, take him out. Actually, 32, attack 20. Yeah, whatever, just take him out. Let's see. What's your defense? Defense 7. Whatever, I bought 2 killing edges anyway. Just die, just die, just... It's okay, you can die now. Yep, okay, cool. We got a Thoron. That'll be good on Etzel, maybe. God. These guys do be looking like fresh EXP, though. Nice, okay, so now what's... Okay, so Violent has 19 attack. Violent has 19 attack. This guy has 6 defense and 11 HP, so let's see. Yep, that'll take him out for sure, but just to be safe, we do have Boa over here who has heals. Nice, alright. Nice, alright. Baraku level up. Strength, speed, HP. Very nice. Glad I did that. And now we just run away for another turn. And next turn we can just freely seize with Violent. Yeah. Yeah, this, I'd overall say this was a very well designed map. This was a very fun map. I was a bit afraid of the split up team at first, because usually that's kind of annoying in Fire Emblem. You know, like that one Fates map, you can just get around it by pairing up everyone anyway. So it doesn't really do much, but in this it was quite fun. High res, unfortunate. In this, I would say this was a well-designed map. Because you could have your right team take out the meteor guy for the left guys, but then the left guys also have to, you have to do it quick enough so the other guys can actually avoid Garnet. So yeah, I'd say this was actually a very well-designed map. And you have the dragon there you can avoid, but you can also kill it to get the treasure. And it's tough. I don't know what we would have done if Sedgar hadn't got that lucky dodge. And now, let's just milk this guy for some good old-fashioned EXP. Before we seize. Or Barst could just kill it, so Tomas can't. Okay. Thank you, Barst. Alright, let's ride. Let's ride. Actually, is it possible to get the thing to... Actually, I'll just use it next chapter, it doesn't matter. Seize. No more treasure or anything? Nope, alright, we're good to go. Seize. Ugh, how could it be? How could it be that I lost to Wolf, Violent, and Sedgar? Oh! Hey, it's Marth. I guess Garnef captured him and planned to use his royal blood. Cause there he is, that's the Lord Sprite. Hey, yep, there's the boy, there's Marth. Oh, I am Marth, son of King Cornelius. Yep, as the game goes on, there's more original ideas, cause I actually quite liked this map. Alright, chapter 11. Nope, it's just the Mathis chapter, okay, thanks game. I praised the original chapter, god. Mathis isn't even here. There's no point. There's literally no point. There's no Mathis. There's no Mathis. Might get Merrick if we go a little over here, though. Which means Excalibur, so that'll be nice. Anyway, with that, we have Marth now, I wonder. Ratty. Nope. Does not look like we have Marth, but our army is still ever-growing. Christ, we have a lot of units. Like, a lot of units. A lot of units. That we're never gonna use. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, remember to subscribe if you like what you see, and bye-bye.